There's a nice trick in Excel to aggregate various sheets. So just to show you the example, what I've got here is a total, and what I want to do is I want to add up the Africa, Europe and Asia divisions. So the one way I could do it is I could go here and I could say equals, and I could go to each of these sections and add them up, and I get my answer. I can copy and paste it. But what happens if someone comes to you and says, listen, we've sold Europe? You would need to come in here and change all these formulas, get rid of Europe. And then they come back to you and say the deal fell through, we actually need Europe back in. You'd have to change the formulas again. So there's a nice way you can do it where you can actually move the sheets in and out and it'll affect the calculations. So I'm just going to delete these. The actual steps in the process are very important. So the way you do this is you click in the cell, you say equals sum open bracket. You then click on a cell or a sheet and the cell you want to add in. So we've done that one. And only at this stage do you hold your shift key down and you go to the very last sheet you want to include and you click. And then you can close your brackets. When I click enter, I get the same number. But if you have a look at the formula, you'll notice that it's sum Africa to Asia cell C5. So what this is telling Excel is it must start on the Africa sheet and go to cell C5, and it must add any other sheet, cell C5, until it gets to the Asia sheet. Because it also makes use of the absolute and relative references, it's possible to copy these down. Let's see how this works now. So you'll see the revenue is 30,300. If we decide that we're getting rid of Europe, all I do is I click on Europe, I drag it outside Asia, and when I go back to the total, can you see the number is 30,100. If the deal falls through and we need to include it again, I click on Europe, I put it in the middle there, go back to total, and notice we're back to 30,300. Just some important points when using this technique. So it's very important when you click the shift button. So just to show you again, I'm just going to delete that. What we do is we say equals sum open bracket. I haven't touched shift yet, we've done nothing. I can go to a sheet, click on the cell, and only then do you click shift and click on the last sheet. If you do it too early, you're going to group your sheets and it's going to start overwriting your formula. So it's very important you do it in that order. So we'll just put it there. Another important point is what you refer to as the first and last sheets. So in this case, we clicked on Africa and Asia, those two. The problem with the way we've done it is that if I wanted to get rid of Africa, I can't, because wherever I move Africa, that formula stays the same. So it'll always look from Africa to Asia, no matter what happens. So a suggestion in this case is to create a sheet, a blank sheet called beginning, and a blank sheet called end, and you'll see I've put arrows on to show that it belongs in there. And when we create this formula, we actually refer to these so that we have the ability to move any one of these. So just to create this formula, equals sum open bracket. Now a little trick, if I click on beginning, I can't actually see where I need to go. So I can go to Africa, click on that first cell, and then go back to beginning, and it remembers where we were. I then hold shift down, click on end, close the bracket, click enter, and I can now copy and paste this down. And you'll see now, if I want to get rid of Asia, I move it outside the end. When I go to the total, you'll see it's a lot smaller. I can put it inside there, go back, and it adds it up. Another benefit of this technique is, let's say we're now going to go into another continent. I don't have to go and change all the calculations. I'm going to go to Europe, right click, say move or copy. We're going to create a copy, and all I need to do is make sure I put it in the right area. So I'm going to put it over here. You'll notice we create Europe 2. Let's put another number in here and a big number. When I go back to my total, notice it's added up. If we don't want that, we could delete it. But my suggestion is, rather than deleting, because you never know when you need it again, you just copy it out of the area, and if you do need it again, you can just easily put it back in. Finally, a word of warning. This only works if you are consistent, if you've applied the good practice rules and you've consistently made sure that related cells are in the same row and same column. So if, for example, Africa was actually, the revenue was in D5, Europe was in C5, and Asia was maybe in E6, you cannot use this technique. You then have to go and manually go and point at each one. So this is a much safer, much better technique, but if you don't build it properly, you have to go the old slow way.